So let's talk about these insane RTX 5090 rumors circling around. The word on the street is that the upcoming NVIDIA RTX 5090 GPU might require a massive power supply upgrade. And if you are thinking, hey, I just upgraded my PSU for the RTX 4090, well, sorry, sucks to be you. The latest rumor is suggesting that the RTX 5090 would need not one, but two 16-pin power connectors. And if that's true, then we are looking at a GPU that is going to demand an insane amount of power. But you know what will make your wallet happy? Cheap Windows 11 license key from our channel sponsor scdkey.com. scdkey is a website where you can buy legit Windows 11 Pro keys for a fraction of the retail price. Microsoft sells Windows 11 license for $200, but if you use the 25% discount coupon code PP25, you can get Windows 11 Pro for only $23.46. Activating your copy of Windows is super easy. So press Windows button plus the S key and you will get this Windows search bar. Type activate and click on activation setting. Next, click on change product key and paste the Windows 11 Pro product key that you purchased from scdkey.com. Click next and voila, your Windows 11 Pro is now fully activated. So use the discount code TB25 when buying Windows license from scdkey.com. Your wallet will thank you and so will I, because when you buy keys from scdkey.com, you are financially supporting this channel. So thank you. Now, if you remember the RTX 4090 launch, you will recall the drama around the 12-volt high power cables. There were some pretty scary reports of these things catching fire. Not exactly what you would want when you are dropping a grand on a brand new GPU. The issue was so concerning that Nvidia eventually had to roll out a new standard, and that was the 12-volt 2x6 connector. Now, this connector has more or less fixed the issue and we haven't heard anything, regarding melting of cables. But here is the kicker. The RTX 5090, according to these leaks, could draw over 550 watts of power, and in some cases, they are saying it might draw up to 600 watts of power. That's nearly maxing out what a single 12-volt high-power cable can handle on its own. And if you are the type who loves to overclock, and let's be real guys, who does not in the PC gaming likes to overclock their GPU? So you are going to need all the power that you can get to run your overclocked GPU. And that's where these two 16-pin connectors will come into play. So what does this mean for gamers and what does this mean for you specifically? Well, if these rumors are true, then you will most likely need to buy a new PSU. And even if your current PSU is fully capable of running a beast GPU like 4090, most likely it will not suffice. So you will need to upgrade to at least a 1200 watt or possibly a 1600 watt PSU just to handle the load from both your CPU and this monster RTX 5090 GPU. There has already been some chatter in the tech world about companies like MSI and Thermaltake releasing PSUs that have these dual 16-pin connectors. In fact, folks from Tweaktown, they just visited an MSI factory in China and they spotted a modular PSU with not one, but two of these 12-volt 2x6 power connectors. When asked, these companies more or less have confirmed that they were preparing for the next generation of GPUs. So yeah, it does appear that these rumors are true, and I get the feeling that these are not bullshit rumors. We most likely will see a top-of-the-line GPU with two 16-pin power connector. It sounds crazy, but I think this is going to happen. Now, on the AMD side of things, rumors are suggesting that AMD is not even trying to play in the high leagues with their RDNA 4 lineup. I think they have already thrown the towel. Word is AMD is focusing more on the mid-range market, which means Nvidia will have the high-end crown pretty much locked down for the foreseeable future, because Intel is also not going to compete with RTX 5090. So what's the takeaway? If you want the best gaming experience, Nvidia RTX 5090 is your only option in the future. But your wallet will take a serious hit. After all, you will be paying not just for the price of the GPU, but also you will have to buy an expensive PSU, and you will have to also take into account your high monthly electric bill. By the way, things are also getting pretty dicey with the current RTX 4090 stock. So over in Germany, there are multiple news reports which are talking about RTX 4090 stocks drying up, and prices are also shooting up. So 3D Center reported that several retailers are almost completely out of RTX 4090 in Europe. And ones who still have them in stock, they are jacking up the price significantly. At this rate, you are looking at anywhere from $2,100 to $2,600 for the RTX 4090, which is nuts. Now, this may suggest that Nvidia might be officially planning to discontinue RTX 4090. So far, no board partners have gone on the record to confirm this news. So it's all whispers and speculation at this point of time. But here is what we do know. In the last 2 years, Nvidia has sold boatloads of RTX 4090, but a significant chunk of that inventory did not go to your average PC gamer. Instead, companies and individuals hungry for powerful compute GPUs, they gobbled up all the stock, especially for tasks like generative AI and for training large language models. So while RTX 4090 might have been oversupplied in theory, it has been notoriously hard to find below its MSRP for the last 2 years or so. This GPU has consistently sold at a premium price. Now guys, full caveat here, everything that I'm saying, this is all speculation, this is all rumor, right? I don't know anything that you don't know already. Obviously, we don't have any official confirmation either from Nvidia or from the board partners. But you know what they say, where there is smoke, there is fire. And in this case, it could be literal fire hazard if you are not prepared for the kind of PSU that these cards would require. Anyway, what are your thoughts on these rumors? Would you be willing to upgrade your PSU for the RTX 5090, or is this starting to feel like an overkill? Please drop a comment below and let me know what you think. And hey, if you found this video helpful, hit the like button, subscribe to this channel, and ring the bell for more updates on all things regarding CPU and GPUs. Next, why don't you guys watch this video over here, and I will see you guys over there. Bye.